Hey guys, it's me, Double D, with the final episode of Pikmin 2. Last time, we explored more of the Dream Den. And in this episode, here we are on the final floor, where their final battle awaits. So, moving onward. I don't need you, White Pikmin. I want an army consisting of entirely yellow Pikmin for one captain, which means Mr. President is going to have an army full of yellow Pikmin. I don't need you, White Pikmin, thank you very much. Olimar will call the rest of the Pikmin and head over this way where everyone awaits. There is Louie in the center over there, which we are now able to rescue him. And now, what you want to do is herd all of your Pikmin to this geyser into a sweet corner. You could use this geyser to regroup on your Pikmin if you don't feel like your numbers are not ideal, but me being the crazy guy that I am, I'm going in with the numbers that we came in with. So, this big arena with Louie in the center, with our army of yellow Pikmin, let's approach Louie.
Is that Louie? Mr. President, I have located Louie resting on a vast amount of treasure. For him to venture to these depths alone, the desire of man is a thing to be feared. But Louie is not moving. Could he have exhausted his strength in reaching these depths? There may be yet time. Quickly, to Louie's aid!
Of course, it's never easy. This is our final battle. This is the Titan Dweevil. Focus on the first part of it. That's the shock therapist. This is why I want you to go forward with an army entirely consisting of yellow Pikmin at the start. Because as you know, lightning will instantly kill your Pikmin. So yeah, watch the Titan Dweevil's colors. It'll indicate what hazard is going to hit you with. Basically, it's a test of see how well you will combat these hazards. Okay, so when he brings out the water hazard, quickly switch tier to Olimar because there is a chance that the bubbles will hit his Pikmin, or rather you're the captain by the exit. So use all your spicy sprays. Oh yeah, flare cannon. That is the second most deadliest of it. If you get caught in the flame, there is no way you're going to escape, and all the Pikmin that are with you will die. Okay, let's spice on up and get to the another flare cannon attack. Okay, yeah, keep whistling your Pikmin in case they get caught in any hazards. Make sure they are safe. By the end of this, you want to make sure you have a total of 30 Pikmin. Okay, he's doing the poison one. He's turning purple. Okay, so I'm going to get to the outside of the arena because it'll never reach the outside of the arena. Be near the outer parts of the arena. And focus on this one first. It's the electricity hazard, which means that should be top priority. Use your spicy sprays because they will increase the power of your Pikmin. Obviously, I would have gone with a more ideal number of Pikmin, but I want to see how I do with the numbers. And it's broken off, which means we are safe to bring in all the rest of our Pikmin. So I might as well get to a safer place. Okay, he's bringing out the monster pump again, which means we get a bubble, which means some of our Pikmin could get hit over there, but it doesn't matter because none of them got hit. Anyway, the shock therapist has been broken off, which means we can be able to use the rest of our Pikmin without any worries. So, okay, what is he going for now? Okay, so our second target will be the flare cannon. As you know, a captain can get easily caught up in it and lose every single Pikmin that he has. Keep whistling if any Pikmin get caught into, well, a hazard. This battle will take long, so be prepared before going forward. Okay, he's using the monster pump again, so I might as- Yeah, the monster pump is pretty much the least of our issues because we can easily whistle back Pikmin that are hit with water. And of course the flare cannon is right out in the open, so we can be able to aim for that. And the bubbles have the tendency to miss. A lot. Okay, no, a lot of our Pikmin are drowning, and the flare cannon is detached. Okay, the comedy bomb is pretty much the least threatening of it, because you can easily escape to the side of the dungeon, and I'm pretty sure the captain won't be stunned if they're hit by it. Pikmin are poisoned. Okay, our next stop is the monster pump, which he is bringing out right now. Okay, nectar up, and throw our Pikmin at him, and then... Okay, yeah. With all of our Pikmin going out on these parts should be no problem at all. Okay, let's get him out of again. Okay, and of course call out any Pikmin that are drowning in these water bubbles. Okay, I'm gonna get him up there. Get him onto the... Okay, comedy bomb, okay. Okay. What I would advise you do is stay away from the treasures that he drops, as tempting as it is to bring him back to the ship while the battle is going on. There is a chance your Pikmin will be caught up in it. Okay, Okay. Pikmin are poisoned, Pikmin are being poisoned. Okay, good. Okay, now time to throw all our Pikmin over to that pump. Okay, he should be out of position where I could easily throw it at him, so I will do that. Now he's doing it faster. Okay, whistle. Okay. Ideally, you want to keep your captain separated. Separated, so I'm going to do just that. Yeah, so I'm gonna have Mr. President over here. Olimar just gonna sit there and do nothing with his group of Pikmin. Yeah. Spice on up. And aim for the monster pump. Okay, it's right there. This is going to take forever because of the amount of throwing that you're going to do and the amount of whistling that you're going to do to get these Pikmin from out of harm's way, and the fact that the Titan Dweevil is constantly moving his parts, so it's not going to be easy to hit. Okay, everyone's drowning, and the monster pump is down, so which means that's only left is the comedy bomb on his butt. At least I believe that's his butt. Okay, yeah, that is his booty. Okay, so let's get that poison bomb. I don't see how funny poison is, but if it's poison, even though it's called a comedy bomb, then it's poisonous. Okay, might as well stay far away and then rush right at him. Okay, not really rush at him, but okay. So yeah, once again, take on the shock therapist first and then go after everything else later. That's basically the gist of how you want to go about fighting the Titan Dweevil. And that's down to the last part. In fact, once we got this down, we are good. We don't have to worry about the Titan Dweevil anymore. Where is our other poison Pikmin? Where are they? Okay, he's doing it again. The unfortunate part is that you'll end up wasting a potion because he's gonna constantly keep doing the comedy bomb attack as his last resort. I probably should have done the monster pup first because it doesn't really do much of anything. Anyway, so we'll take on the comedy bomb first. Okay. I don't know if the captains will be stunned. Whistle them around. Our poison Pikmin together. Okay. Comedy bomb is in position. Okay, captains are stunned. Okay, yeah. Bad idea. Okay, I'm gonna have to throw all my Pikmin up to that bomb over there. I am missing a lot, and that is bad. I need to get to a safe place. Or actually, I could just circle around it until the poison expires, whichever comes first. All my Pikmin are suffering. Okay, that one. And he is dead. I couldn't get to him in time. I am sorry, Red, but... Okay. Yeah, I think I just circle around in the direction the poison is spinning. Okay. Nectar up. He's in a pretty much Dirkish location because he positioned himself around all the other treasures. Okay, what direction he's going to? Okay. Whistle. Okay, that Red... sorry, Yellow. I know I should have watched you. Okay, that Yellow just died. I'm missing a lot. I don't think any of them are hitting that comedy bomb as far as I'm concerned. Okay. Now time to hit him. I see Pikmin suffering, but I'm just gonna leave him there because, well... Now we're down to 60 Pikmin. So, by the end of this, you want to make sure you have at least 30 Pikmin. Because each of these treasures have at least 30 Pikmin needed to carry. Okay. I might as well have to reposition myself so I'm in a more favorable position. Okay. Actually, will this work? I want to petrify him with the Super Bitter Spray. It does! Okay, so I might as well go after the Comedy Bomb while he's petrified. Okay. Comedy Bomb! Let's go! Okay, go for the bomb. I missed. Okay, now Pikmin are being poisoned somewhere. Okay. Anyway, so, petrify him once again. Okay, and then go after the bomb. Okay, after that, it should be on its way to being detached. Hopefully, very soon. No, it didn't happen. That was my last Super Bitter Spray too. Okay, okay. This is also my last Super Spicy Spray, so... so I want to make it count. Okay, oh no, no, not the majority of my Pikmin squad! Okay. Okay. Okay, I think Pikmin died during the poison attack, but that's... okay, 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 okay. Okay, I'm gonna go separate my captains real quick so that to make sure Olimar is not among us. Okay, Olimar. You'll be taking down this one. Mr. President will be standing by. Standing by. Not again. Okay. Yeah, this fight can take forever because once he's down to one attack, he will be using it over and over again. And depending on how good your Pikmin throw is, it will take forever just to even get them down. Or get the last part off of him. Unfortunately. Mr. President! Whistle the Pikmin! Whistle the Pikmin are suffering! And one died. Okay. Okay, maybe that wasn't such a good idea. Okay. Okay, 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 okay. Okay, why am I missing? I should not be missing so much. Uh-oh. Okay, 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 okay. Oh no. We are losing Pikmin. We are losing Pikmin a lot. And we're down to the last spicy spray. I want to save it. I want to save it until I absolutely need it. Okay. Okay, okay, there are... okay. 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 Okay, okay. Now I'm in a really tight spot. Purple, please don't... poison. Okay, okay. Okay, 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 okay. Let's get him down, let's get it down. Okay. Maybe I should have done the monster pump last, because at least with the monster pump, you could be able to easily predict where the bubbles are gonna go. Okay. Okay, let's see. Let's get this down. Hopefully this should be the last. Okay, no, it's not. Okay. Okay, maybe I should have just started off with yellow Pikmin. Okay. Okay, let's get all to yellows and... okay, I need to get all the Pikmin are suffering over there too. But, okay. Okay, Pikmin died. Okay. Okay. Okay, I believe this is enough. Okay. Okay. Okay, yeah, I'm getting really nervous right about now because that comedy bomb has yet to come off and there is no health bar indicating how much it'll take before it gets detached. Because like all Dweevils, they don't have a health bar for the item they wear as hats. Or equipment, for that matter. And we lost another Pikmin to poison. Okay. This is... I probably should have just saved the comedy bomb for... or the monster pump for last, because at the very least, at least I don't have to worry about Pikmin being poisoned. I mean, drowning Pikmin is no problem. I probably should have... okay, okay, there. Okay, 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 okay. Might as well get all the Pikmin here. Okay. Okay, okay, you know what? I say screw it. I'm just gonna separate my squad real quick. And use our remaining yellows to take out the comedy bomb, because it's way too high up to reach. Okay. Okay, I'm in position. Now's the time to throw some at the comedy bomb. Okay, hopefully it should be down. If not, well... okay, okay. Yeah, probably not the best way to go about this because, well... well... okay. Okay, okay. Now we just throw it on there. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Okay, one is suffering, but it got him easily. Okay, okay. Let's see. Okay. If I have anything to say about this boss, it's sort of disappointing because, yeah, it is a test to see how much of Pikmin knowledge you know, and the fact that it's using all the hazards against you, meaning that you pretty much have to be smart with your Pikmin, and that's great and all. But the fact that they... that he constantly uses the same attacks over and over the less he has... Yeah, that just makes it go on forever. I mean, take the plasma raid from Pikmin 3. He does the attacks no matter how much his health is, and the comedy bomb is down. Yes, with that, he is down to his last legs, which in this case, he is absolutely harmless. All you have to do is throw Pikmin at him, and that is the end of it. The worst he'll do is just knock Pikmin off there or going off of him. But by that time, you already have Pikmin ready to be thrown back at him. I mean, you can just get some Pikmin working on the treasures while killing him, but that's pretty much it. The only thing he has worrisome about him is the fact that he has lots of health, but really, if you're patient, then you don't have to worry about that. I'm just gonna stop the collecting of treasures real quick so I can get to work on this. And yeah, that's pretty much all there is to it. Like I said, the only downside is that he has a lot of health, which makes defeating him take forever. And I'm out of spicy spray, so... Well, I only have one. But I want to save it, so I don't have to worry about it later. Oh, you know what? It's the end of the game. I can use it right around... I'm gonna get all my Pikmin here. And spice them up, and there we go! There we go. Let's get all our Pikmin on there. And... During the last legs of his health, he will be, well, almost dead. In fact, his health is almost down, and he is dead! Now we just watch him slowly dissolve as I get my Pikmin to work on the treasures. And, wow. Dissolving. Pretty much the worst way any organism could die. Anyway, Louie is saved.
Louie? Are your life functions fading? No, he appears only to have fainted. He's always running into trouble. Instruct the Pikmin to carry him. There is not enough room for him in the cockpit anymore. We will have to keep him in the cargo hold with the treasure hoard.
And with that, that is the last of them. That is the last of the bosses, the last of the treasures. Well, we still have to have these treasures to carry back. And so much fighting has been all down to this. But first, our treasures. The first of which is the poison bomb known as the comedy bomb. I swear there was nothing funny about what it did to me during the last leg of its life before it became so harmless. Our next one is a torch. In fact, it is known as I said before, the flare cannon. Pretty straightforward and looks like something you could find in a science lab or a barbecue. It's a gas torch. Okay, so let's get all of our Pikmin started on carrying this thing, and we need 5 Pikmin to carry Louie back. And that's more than enough. Okay, so I'm gonna have a Purple Pikmin assist on that one. Our next one, a gigantic faucet. You are known as the monster pump. I should have gotten you first or second. Actually, I should have just saved you for last because at least it would have made the Titan Dweevil easier to deal with. But anyway, there's the last one. Well, wait, who's gonna carry back? No, I'm gonna save Louie for last. I'm gonna go with this device. The one that should electrocute our Pikmin if we are not prepared, which is the entire reason why I started off with yellows. I've seen a lot of people start off with 100 yellows to take on this fight, and it works very well. Anyway, this trollish device that will kill any Pikmin that are not yellow is known as the Shock Therapist. More like the Executioner, because it executes any Pikmin that are not yellow. Anyway. Here's Louie. Only 10 Pokos, and he is known as the King of Bugs. How fitting he was controlling the Dweevil. Or rather, the Dweevil was controlling him. Who knows? Anyway, you look around here. A lot of people say this looks a lot like a GameCube. And I guess I can see it. I mean, this is where this This is where the disc would be placed at. I guess this whole place is where the disc is, and this is the outer edges of within that disc slot. But yeah. So with that, let's get into the geyser and exit the very last dungeon. Holy crap, that's a lot of treasure that we have collected. No wonder it's called the Dream Den, and half our Pikmin squad is dead. But that's all the treasures in Pikmin 2. Let's leave. And just in time, because sunset is just about to start. Okay, so let's see how we did in the grand scheme of things. That's pretty much... Oh my god. Seeing it compared to my first playthrough, it's a miracle how I ever survived this playthrough at all. Yeah, the nature of this game can get really jerkish at times. Seriously, we have... That's a lot of red pigment. Okay, that's not... Okay, yeah. Everything is inferior to my first playthrough, we get it. So, that is every single treasure in the game. And basically just record your score once you collected all the treasures, but oh man. Wow, 19 days to collect all the treasures? That's a new record, if I've ever seen it. Pikmin lost, that shouldn't be that big of a surprise. Pikmin lost in battle, and yet, that's not a surprise. Pikmin left behind! At least, at the very least, I can keep up my track record of not having any Pikmin being left behind. I went through the entirety of Pikmin 1 without any Pikmin being left behind at the night, and the same holds true for Pikmin 2. At least I got that to look forward to. And, of course, when inevitably let's play Pikmin 3, which I don't know when that'll be, I hope to keep that track record straight. Because the fact that I went through so much crap, and none of them died due to being left behind, is just awesome. And, of course, we lost a lot of fire. That's mostly my fault. Water! Again, that's mostly my fault. Electricity! Again, mostly my fault. Explosions! Stupid explosions. Poison! I'm willing to bet that's because of the Titan Dweevil. Pig- Pikmin born! Okay, I didn't really focus much on populating the Pikmin because I didn't dedicate a day to do so. Red Pikmin born! Not very much because I didn't dedicate the day. Yellow Pikmin born! Same thing. Blue Pikmin born! Which, the same thing. White Pikmin born! With all my purple Pikmin grinding, I'm surprised I got that number up really fast. And purple Pikmin born! Not really a surprise. And total playtime, wow. I didn't really beat my personal record, but wow. And so, once again, Olimar's company is prosperous. Of course, it probably won't be that long if Pikmin 3 was any indication. So, with that, I suppose I should end things off here right now because this is the final episode of Pikmin. So, of course, there's going to be some bonus episodes with other things I have yet to go over. So, next time on Pikmin 2, we're going to be starting off the bonus episode to see what is unlocked. So, I'll see you guys next time. Bye! And it starts off straight at the world map, seriously?